What are you listening to? What are you allowing to come into your ears and into your eyes? You know, this is what I'm thinking about today, because it's those things that we listen to that determine the output in our lives. Input determines output. And as a man thinks in his heart, so he is. It's out of the abundance of the heart that the mouth speaks. And what is it that determines what we say? Our heart does. And what fills our heart is what we give our attention to, you know, what we give our time, what we give our attention to. I'm quite often listening to a lot of YouTube videos and listening to a lot of different things, but it's really important, you know, what we listen to. And I notice the difference between when I'm listening to, say, the word a lot, or when I'm just listening to lots of random stuff about finance or different things that are going on in the world, how it makes me feel and what impact it has on my life. You know, there's a big difference. The Bible says, one of the first scriptures that really spoke to me when I first got saved back in 2003 was, God is guard your heart with all diligence, for out of it flow the issues of life. And what does that mean, to guard your heart? You know, it's what is it that comes into your heart? It's what you listen to, it's what you see. Those are the things that come into our heart. So how can we guard our hearts? The Bible says, let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which you were also called in one body, and be thankful. But how can I let the peace of Christ rule in my heart? He says, he will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on you, because he trusts in you. So to let the peace of God guard my heart, if I keep my mind stayed on him, he will keep me in perfect peace. Why would I keep my mind stayed on God and his word? Why would I do that? Because I love him, because he first loved me, because it gives me peace, it gives me strength, because life-giving content in through my ears and through my eyes means life-giving content coming out through my mouth. Like we said at the beginning, it's out of the abundance of the heart that the mouth speaks. And life and death are in the power of the tongue, and those who love it shall eat its fruit. You know, and because we trust in God as our source, as our protector, you know, these are the reasons. We need to make sure we're listening to the right things, seeing the right things. The word shall not depart from my mouth. You know, keep it in my mouth continually. Attend to my words, it says in Proverbs. And it says, let them not depart from your eyes. Keep them in the midst of your heart, for they are life to those who find them, and strength to all your flesh. So today, that's really what I wanted to talk about. Look at all this life around me. Look, you know, good soil, just like in the heart. You know, good things in, good things out. Look at this place, full of life. This is what our life should be like, full of life. Look at this place, full of peace. You hear the birds singing in the trees. So today I just want to talk about, you know, making sure we're putting good things in, good things out. What are we giving our time and attention to, you know? Desire, as Reverend Coyler said, follows attention. What you give your time to and your attention to will determine what you desire. So make sure you're giving your attention to the right things, listening to the right things, seeing the right things. Put the word of God in your sight as often as possible. Listen to the word of God as often as possible. Think about it, meditate on it. It'll keep you in perfect peace. It will guard your heart. It'll help you to have life-giving words in your heart, so that when you speak, you'll speak life, and you'll have strength, and you'll have good results, and good fruit will abound. Those that love it shall eat its fruit. And so today, that's what I'm thinking about. That's what I want to share. Put good things in, put the word in, get good things out, and I'll see you again tomorrow.